Welcome to Onyx Pages. I'm in Jerry. It is Saturday. Tomi's birthday is tomorrow. Yay! And we are on our way to Terre Bleue. She's sitting right beside me. She's like, girl, I love you, but girl. So we are on our way to Terre Bleue. And Terre Bleue is a lavender farm in Milton, Ontario. You wanna go to a lavender farm? I think you wanna go to a lavender farm. We're gonna go to a lavender farm. You're gonna come with us to the lavender farm. And so apparently it's really beautiful and there's obviously a lot of lavender. And while I'm there, I think I'm gonna do one of the tags because I just realized that you can find out on YouTube if you've been tagged in other booktubers' videos by searching for your name or the name of your channel in the YouTube video search box, and then you can scroll through all of the videos to see whether your name comes up in somebody else's comments. So that's kind of cool. So I did that and I realized that I've been tagged in a number of different videos and I had absolutely no idea. So apologies to everyone, but I'm gonna do a few of those tags today. Or maybe one, let's be honest, probably just one. Maybe one in the field. Anyway, I hope that you enjoy this vlog. Bye. We're at the lavender farm. It's very exciting.
That must be nice for the horses, eh?
I'm sitting in the lavender field, and I'm very okay with that. I wanted to tell you a little bit about what I'm currently reading. I'm halfway through Nisi, Shawl's Everfair, and I had a hard time getting through part one, and I realized why, because I watched a bunch of review videos about the book, and I understand that it is definitely a book that you have to give some, like, hardcore respect to when you're reading it. It's not a book that you can pick up and put down on the subway or in, like, you know, 15 minute breaks in the day and that kind of stuff, because the chapters are super short. They're like 5 to 12 pages long. A lot happens in a chapter, and then each chapter is written from a different perspective, in a different setting at a different time. And so if you are reading it in little fits and starts, it can be hard to get a sense of the actual arc of the plot. So I'm gonna do my best when I get through part two to do so in longer intervals with less distractions, because there's a lot going on and Nisi Shawl is such a nuanced writer that she packs a lot in 10 words, right? And she does a lot of showing as opposed to telling, so you really have to, it is hot, so you really have to pay attention to what's going on. But so far, I'm really enjoying it. I'm loving the way that she seamlessly weaves technology into the plot and into history. It's almost like this actually happened. Like, it's one of the few books that I've read that feels so, it feels mundane, like the magic in it feels mundane, even though there's a lot of magical stuff that's going on. And the queerness is so vibrant and so seamless, and the relationships are subtle, and there's a lot going on, lots of romance, a lot of intrigue, a lot of humor, and yeah, you know, for a really brutal time in history, this retelling is actually a much lighter read than I thought. So I am really liking Nisi Shawl's Everfair right now, now that I know how to read it, and I look forward to giving you a review. I don't know if I told you this, but I'm very afraid of bees. And I'm not sure if you can hear it, but there be bees, like, everywhere. I'm gonna show you a few.